Good morning, students. Today we will learn evaluation and measurement. First of all, we will define evaluation. According to Goodcarter, evaluation is the process of ascertaining or judging the value of something by careful appraisal. According to Ralph Taylor, evaluation is the process of determining to what extent the education objectives are being realized. Then we will see the philosophy of evaluation. Each individual should receive the education that most fully allows him to develop his potential. Each individual should be placed, he should contribute to society and receives personal satisfaction in so doing. Fullest development of individual requires recognition of his essential individuality along with some rational appraisal by him. The judgments required in assessing an individual's potential are, in their composition, difficult to make and filled with error. Such error can be reduced but never eliminated. Hence, any evaluation can never be considered final. Every form of appraisal will have critics, which is part to change and improvement. What are the purposes of evaluation? We will see the purposes. Number one, diagnosis. Number 2, prediction. Number 3, grading. Number 4, selection. Number 5, guidance. Number 6, exploration. Next 1, evaluation of program. Evaluation of teachers. Last 1, motivation. Okay. Then we will discuss about purposes of evaluation in nursing education. Number 1, to determine the level of knowledge and understanding of students. To determine the level of students' clinical performance. To become aware of specific difficulties of individual students or an entire class as a basis for further teaching. To diagnose each student's strength and weakness and to suggest remedial measures which may be needed. Next 1, to encourage students' learning by measuring their achievements and informing them of their success. To help students to become increasingly self-directing in their study. To help students to acquire that attitude of skills in self-evaluation. Next 1, to provide the additional motivation of examination that provide opportunity to practice critical thinking, the appreciation of principles and making judgments. Next 1, to estimate the effectiveness of teaching and learning techniques of subject, content and institutional media in attaining the goals of the program. To gather information needed for administrative purpose. Then we will see principles of evaluation. What are the principles? See, determining and clarifying what is to be evaluated always has priority in the evaluation process. Next 1, evaluation techniques should be selected according to the purpose to be served. Comprehensive evaluation requires a variety of evaluation techniques. Next 1, proper use of evaluation techniques requires an awareness of both their limitations and strengths. Evaluation is a means to an end, not an end itself. Then many things we can see in evaluation, such as characteristics. See the characteristics here. Evaluation is a continuous process. You know, usually, evaluation includes academic and non-academic subjects. Evaluation is procedure for improving the product, discovering the needs of an individual and designing learning experiences. Evaluation is purpose-oriented. Then see the functions of evaluation. Functions are to make provisions for guiding the growth of individuals and students, to diagnose the weakness and strength of students, to locate areas where remedial measures are needed, to provide a basis for a modification of the curriculum and the course, to motivate students toward better attainment and growth, to test the efficiency of teachers in providing learning experiences. Then we can see that many types of evaluation, like number one, feasibility evaluation, number two, formative evaluation, number three, certifying evaluation, number four, maintenance evaluation, number five, maximum performance evaluation, number six, criteria referenced evaluation, number seven, norm reference evaluation. You should read the detail in books, okay? Evaluation process. Processes are here: identifying the purpose of evaluation, identifying the time frame, determining when to evaluate, selecting the evaluators, choosing an evaluation design or framework or model, selecting an evaluation instruments, collecting data, interpreting data, reporting the findings, using the findings, considering the cost of evaluation, such as the things of evaluation. If you have any doubt, you can ask me frankly. Okay, tomorrow we will learn measurement. Okay.